Hey guys, it's Samantha with Blue Feather Homestead. Today I wanted to talk to you about medical supplies. You know, everything that's going on right now in the world, I thought this would be a good time for me to go through my medical supplies and see what I have on hand. And as I was going through my absolute mess, I have stuff everywhere. I had stuff everywhere. Now I have it all kind of in a pile here that I need to go through and get organized. And I thought, what would be the most important thing for me to have during a crisis? Okay, I can't get to the doctor, you know, can't get to the store, just some of the things that I would have on hand. So I guess let's just get started. I think skin integrity would be one of the first things that I would start with. If you get a scratch, you know, or anything else, a cut, whatever, you want to get that cleaned up just as soon as possible before, you know, to prevent the spread of infection. So let's start with some peroxide just to clean out that wound. Peroxide is also good for your mouth, your ears. If you have an abscessed tooth, can't get to the dentist or whatever, you're going to mix this with a little bit of water, swish it around your mouth. If you don't have penicillin, you're going to be hurting, right? This will relieve your pain, and that will clean the infection in your teeth. I worked for a doctor. I'm a nurse. I'm not a practicing nurse right now, but I worked for a doctor who was absolute old school, okay? Somebody come in with an ear infection, something in their ear, we would lay them down on a table, mix peroxide and water together in a cup. I'd have a syringe and just squirt that stuff into the ear, and it just would drain out. And we tell them, you might be a little bit dizzy when you leave here, but I mean, that's how we cleaned it out. We cleaned out their ears with peroxide. Okay, wound care, in teeth infections, gum infections, ears, to clean out your ears. So that's good for that. Also, alcohol, I have this alcohol. I don't know where my clear alcohol is, but this is also good for if you have like poison ivy and stuff, it's good for that itch, relieve it, and it'll dry it out. This green stuff is. The other stuff you want to use also for, you know, cuts and scrapes and things like that to get it cleaned up. I have, what do I have here? Some gauze pads. It looks like I've got some scissors stashed in here for that. These are just some that I used to use. Here's some pretty good looking scissors there. Those almost look like hair cutting scissors, but anyway, you've got some scissors here. Any kind of scissors will do. And you don't have to be a nurse to do all this stuff. This stuff you can buy at the store, okay? You want to get you some sterile pads also. I've got some around here somewhere. Band-aids. Always keep tons of band-aids for your wounds, okay? Also, you could probably keep some Kotex pads around, you know, if you don't have this stuff available or whatever, you could use those for wounds, stomach wounds, things like that. You know, those pads are good. Looks like I've got these here. Let's go on to sprains and things like this. I am notorious. These came from the Dollar Tree. Look here, wrist support, knee support, ankle support. I have these. I get them at the Dollar Tree. Trust me, you ask my kids, my husband, anything. If anybody sprains their little ankle, I don't care if it's barely, you're going to get an ACE bandage on it just because it makes it feel 100% better. And early intervention is the key, okay? Get wrapped up. And then also, you would want to give some ibuprofen, okay? I've got kids, children's ibuprofen. I have adults' ibuprofen around here somewhere. But anyway, you know, to keep the swelling down, get some ice on it, get you ACE bandage on there, okay? Next thing is going to be probably just regular Tylenol. You have children's Tylenol and you have adult Tylenol, and that's going to be for to, you know, bring down. If you have a fever, you want to keep your thermometer also. I don't know where my thermometer is, but keep a thermometer on hand to monitor, you know, that situation. If you need to, you know, give Tylenol to reduce. If a child has a fever that's too high, they could go into a seizure, okay? So, you know, try to bring that down, okay? A lot of people will say to let them go ahead and have that temp, work it out, you know, whatever. It's fighting infection. I totally understand that. I get it. But, you know, you don't want them to go into a seizure if it's way too high. Bring it down. I'm totally into herbs. I'm into oils. I'm into all of that. I'm into natural. But anyway, it's got a time and a place, right? Let's go into upper respiratory infections. I just recently did a video on COVID testing at home because I've just been feeling horrible. My lungs feel yucky. My other kids have also felt yucky. So we did a COVID test on one of my videos. But you should always keep some mucinex on hand because you want to keep that mucus out of your lungs. You don't want to just, you know, lay in bed with that mucus just pulling in your lungs. Okay, pulling, P-O-O-L. That liquid will just stay down there. in your lungs, and that will cause pneumonia. Okay, so you want to get it out, get that mucus out of there. So Mucinex is good for that. You know, get that, keep moving, okay? Don't just lay around with that all the time. You need, if you do, you know, have some kind of lung issues going on, cold or whatever, try to keep moving. Turn over in bed, get up and walk if you can. Get up and walk it out and do some breathing exercises in through your nose. Hold it in as long as you can, out through your mouth. Slowly. Breathing exercises, that's so good for your lungs. All right, now let's talk diarrhea, okay? Oh gosh. Diarrhea, man, that'll get you. You have to watch your kids. You don't want them to get dehydrated. You should probably always try to keep some electrolytes on hand. And as a matter of fact, this stuff right here, good stuff right here, apple cider vinegar. We'll talk about that later. But anyway, that I have some anti-diarrheal medicine here. You want to get that like probably post 48 hours because, you know, you do want to get the whatever the yuck is out of you, of course, but you don't want to let it go too far, okay? You don't want to let it go too long. That's bad. So here's your anti-diarrheal medicine. Let's see. Let's talk about Benadryl. Always have Benadryl. I have adult Benadryl here. I have a children's Benadryl. This is always good for just seasonal allergies. It's also good for nausea. When I worked at the hospital, we treated people that had nausea, insomnia, anxiety. It's just good for all sorts of things. So always have your Benadryl on hand. So I've got Tylenol, Benadryl, anti-diarrheal, Mucinex. Those are some of the things. Peroxide alcohol. Also for your skin integrity, when you do clean up your wounds, you're going to want some antibiotic cream on there, right? You want to put that on there. Okay. And your Band-Aids. You always want to have Band-Aids. I also have a can of burn relief here. This is something that you don't necessarily maybe need to have. I do personally think that I should always have this on hand because it seems like somebody's always getting burned around here. I have this in a can. You just spray that on there for relief, okay? That'll relieve some of the pain. And then I have some silver salt here that you can also spray kind of around it. And that is so good for healing. Silver salt is what we used at the doctor's office in the hospital. And it's just like a cream, an ointment that you would put on there. And I mean, it is so good for healing. If you have eggs, when I worked in a burn unit in my clinicals, they would give them, the burn patients, they would give them an egg with every meal, a hard-boiled egg. Do you know why? Because it has cholesterol. The cholesterol is good to build up your skin and to help heal that wound, okay? The cholesterol is. Tell me cholesterol's bad. Anyway, so we've got that. Here's the thermometer. Apple cider vinegar. I'm going to go back to this. This is just amazing stuff, okay? It's good for indigestion. It's good for yeast infections. If you feel like you're getting a yeast infection, drink some of this. Good for your tummy. If you have a tummy ache or whatever, drink some of this. Mix it with water, of course. You can Google it. You can look on here. It has things on here that it's good for. Apple cider vinegar, and it has to have with the mother. And you don't have to have this brand. I'm sorry. You can have generic. I bought it at Walmart before. Shake it up before you use it. But this stuff is good for everything. You can even put this on your skin if you have a boo-boo or whatever. It'll help, man. It helps, okay? This stuff is really good. Hopefully that helps somebody. And some cough drops. I think that would probably be it. Hopefully I didn't go too fast. I'm just trying to get a whole lot of info into one video. Hopefully that helps you guys out a little bit. I'm going to try to get organized. I'll show you on my table the big mess I have. Oh my goodness, I need to get organized. But anyway, you know, I'm not going to get political right now, like I said, but you might want to start getting prepared for some things, you know. It's not going to hurt to be prepared. If you don't have the money just to go and buy all this junk at one point, you know, every grocery trip, just buy one thing. Buy one thing. It's just like these. I didn't buy these all at one time. Anytime I went to the store, this is like years worth. I didn't buy all this at one time. I'd like see one and pick it up. Like, why not? Pick this up. Why not? Just throw it in the basket. It's a dollar extra. You know, I get generic Tylenol. I get generic ibuprofen. I get generic Benadryl. Most of the things I get are all generic. Just pick one thing up at a time. You know, I'm a homesteader. I'm a modern homesteader, okay? Yes, I am a homesteader. But our main goal as homesteaders is to be self-sufficient, right? To be able to help your family, be able to help yourself, be able to help your neighbors, be able to bless anybody around that's in need, right? I became a nurse just because I love science and I love helping people. And I think that, you know, now is probably a good time to start getting ready. There might be a point in time when you can't get to the doctor. You're not going to be able to go to the store for, you know, just easy peasy, go get you a gallon of milk or some butter or some meat or whatever. You know, like I said, I'm a homesteader and I have meat here. I have, you know, I can. And if you don't do that, if you don't, you know, can your own things, have your own meat or whatever, then start stocking up a little bit. Just go buy one can of vegetables, you know, each trip. Buy a can of vegetables, buy chicken, whatever. Put it in the freezer. One thing at a time. You know, that's all we can do. Excuse my football schedule back here. This is for the school's football schedule. All the sports that are going on, you know, for the town here, okay? We've got that hanging right in the kitchen wall, right on the kitchen wall. Anyway, I told you I was going to show you my mess, and I will. This is my mess, y'all. I've got some organizing to do. I've just got this box full of junk just thrown in here. Would you look at this? Oh, my goodness. Yeah, all this stuff. Anyway. Hey, you guys, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do. And don't forget to hit the notification bell. Be sure to hit that for more fun and informative videos. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye.